Therese Dupree is a production designer that I've wanted to work with for years, and she's turned me down film after film after film. She says it was because schedule, but I don't believe her. Finally, I got a chance to work with her, and it was a great collaboration.
We open our season with Swan Lake. Done to death, I know, but not like this.
One of the joys of working with Darren Aronofsky is how organic he approaches his films. And as Darren and I started to talk about Swan Lake and the stage set and how abstracted we wanted that to be and how modern we wanted that to be, it started moving towards a very, very specified, minimal look.
I had the craziest dream last night about a girl who was turned into a swan, but her prince falls for the wrong girl and she kills herself.
The one thing I really wanted to do was get away from the computer and be outside and be inspired by what is outside. And it not only was the trees, but I started to see the palette of the film in terms of Swan Lake.
And one of the important things that Darren and I really worked hard for was to get movement in the set pieces. We did not want any stagnant still pieces. Everything has a touch of photorealism throughout, again, to make it a little more modern, a little more unexpected. And I've gone out of my way to make sure that there's a little bit of the Swan Lake stage set in almost every location. In Leroy's apartment, you'll see that it's all black and white. You'll see that there's a lot of tree imagery or nature imagery. In Leroy's office, I actually had a sample of the cliff in the background and some rolled up drawings, all very subtle, but it's a common thread that I've tried to keep throughout the movie into each location. And I always put together a palette very early in the movie so that all the department heads, my department, wardrobe, lighting, were all in sync for that particular look, because it will affect the entire movie.
She was able to really create a big canvas for us. It's a very controlled palette.
Black, white, silvers, grays, greens, and pinks. Nina's room in the apartment is actually the only warm place in the apartment. It's pink. It's the only time we were using a little bit of warmth in there. But it'll be very obvious that it's a child's room, and the control that her mother has on her, you can sense just from the production design in that room.
Oh, shh, almost done.
We also wanted to use mirrors in the film.
In the world of ballet, there's mirrors everywhere. Dancers are always looking at themselves. And so their relationship to their reflection is a huge part of who they are. And in Black Swan, it kind of takes on a whole nother meaning. And so visually, we really are pushing what it means to look in a mirror. And when you translate that into cinema, you know, you can start to do some really scary, frightening, unsettling things.
It's really about the arc of Natalie's character in these environments.